Hector Trevino.
Present.
Mari Guajardo.
Here.
Isaac Smith.
Here.
Alma Caso.
Here.
Bobby Carrillo.
Here.
Ben Cantu.
Here.
Rudy Beltran.
Here.
Eran Figueroa. Erica Sharafa.
People missing, do we have motions?
I'll make a motion to excuse the absent members.
Second.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Okay, number two, item administrative, letter A, approval of minutes for March 29, 2023, the regular called meeting.
I make a motion, we approve the minutes.
We have a first. We have a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Item passes. Item B, status report on the spring recreation, athletics, aquatics, after-school programs, and urban ecology.
Good afternoon, Abel Molina, after-school program supervisor. I'm here to report on the after-school program. There's not a whole lot to report on other than I'm just kind of finalizing the numbers for the students enrolled into the program compared to last year. We're a little bit over 400 over than what we enrolled last year, so it's good news to hear that, you know, the program is slowly creeping back up to what it used to be. So other than that, staff's good, kids are loving it. So any questions regarding it?
It ends when the school year ends?
Yeah, it ends, I believe the first week of June is when it ends, and that same week or the week after is when we'll start enrolling for the fall semester and spring semester for 2023-2024.
How far away are we from like full capacity where we're at pre-pandemic?
I would say we're short about 200 kids compared to when we first started, because the number for when the program first started in 2018, it was around 1,000 kids that we had enrolled for the year. So right now we're at 850, so we're getting there. We're pretty close to it. So any questions? No? All right. Questions, appreciate you.
Comments?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Roel Hinojosa, athletic supervisor. I'm going to say for Jennifer, who's not here with us because she's out there working the baseball games, and Sean Martin, who couldn't be here with us either. So Sean has prepping for the boys' high school summer league. He's already passing out flyers, going out to all the schools, and inviting everyone for both boys and girls, actually.
Basketball?
Yeah. I think it's games are still going to be held at Southwest. And this is, again, starts in May, and it goes through June, I believe. It ends in June. I just started registering for, we already have five teams for our girls' high school soccer league. I'm hoping to get started within a couple weeks. Hopefully I'll end somewhere around June as well. We have a lot of interest. We have actually 15 teams that are interested in it, so hopefully we get everybody to come in. For Pony baseball, softball, it's going really, really well. Haven't really had any major hiccups. I think next week it's the official start of the midseason tournaments. So those brackets are about to be sent out. So we'll see where our teams end up and what ages we get to host here. And pretty much for athletics, that's it. Oh, I'm just getting ready for the summer. Start getting ready for our soccer camp, football camp, basketball camp, volleyball, softball, and kickball camp. So pretty busy summer. Y'all have any questions for any of the athletic programs?
No.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Hello. Adam Diaz, aquatic supervisor. We are also getting ready for aquatics, the summertime, and we are getting, you know, the pools ready. We're doing maintenance at the water park, the natatorium, you know, it's a busy little area there too. So we've been averaging about 150 lap swimmers per month at each facility. We are hiring right now for lifeguards for the summertime. So if you all know students, anybody that needs a summer job, you know, we are hiring. So let's see what else.
Is that for the pool, the aquatic center, or the
for both?
Or for both?
For both. Yes, sir. For both.
What number would they contact? contact for an interview or to drop an application?
They can go online. Everything is online. Okay. They can go online and register online, and everything's there, and it'll.
Okay. Thank you.
A couple of spots or a couple of steps they have to take. We are also getting ready for our TAF program, our swim TAF program. We're going to start next month already, so we're doing registration already for TAF. We're excited because we're getting interest from not only Pharr kids, but other places that want to come swim in our at our facility because everybody loves it. So we are kind of narrowing down the things for swim lessons and the activities that we're going to have at the aquatic center. So we're excited. We're getting ready. Do y'all have any questions of aquatics? Thank you.
Good afternoon, Sergio Lanis, Parks and Rec Director. Sarah Guerra is not here today. She had some stuff with her daughter. Everybody's got their scholarship stuff, and their kids are seniors, so she's her recreation programs. She's just going to wrap it up next week. She's got the recital at 6 p.m. on the 20th, April 20th, there at the Pepe Salinas, and that's to wrap up her spring programs. And then next week, they'll start registration for, we're going to do the all day after school. It's like a recreation camp where the kids will come in. They'll be rotating throughout the whole day. And it's basically an all day thing. Abel's, really instrumental in organizing that program, and him and Sarah tag team that stuff. So we'll start registration for that. We'll put out the flyer next week. That way kids can register, right? Last summer we had a couple hundred kids, so hopefully we'll get the same turnout. And I don't want to use the word lock in, but they're basically there all day. They're there from the morning till the afternoon. So they go from each class is about an hour and a half, and then they rotate throughout the rec center. So they get PSA will be there, breakfast and lunch. So that's one of our bigger programs going on in the summertime. And then also, I think she had mentioned May 1st. She'll start doing registration for theater. Theater is one of our more popular ones. That'll be at PSA. We're starting off at PSA North for practice. And then once we do the play, I believe we're moving to Southwest, the auditorium. But we'll communicate that with the parents. But that one is a little tricky. That one does fill up. So it's kind of a first come, first serve. So whoever registers, you can only take so many kids. It's you don't want to get 100 kids, right? And then not everybody gets a part. So we kind of cap it. That's the reason for that. And then the ones that we can help, that can help out with lights for the tech stuff, we also have. But that one fills up immediately. So she'll get that information out. And I think this year they're doing the Lion King. So looking forward to it. Yeah. Hannah didn't come in today. She had done at the nature park. She was doing these this really cool thing where they were painting these parking space things where she invited the community. She set aside, I think she had 72 spots. You basically reserve a parking spot and then you go out there and you paint. And it's kind of just to bring awareness to the nature and stuff like that. The butterfly, just being good stewards in the city. And I think she opened it up on Friday and she had a really good turnout already. I think she got rid of most of the spots. She had like 60 some people register, and then this weekend I was out there Sunday night and there was 20 people out there painting. So we'll have pictures for y'all next month. But that was really cool. So it's a water-based paint. So next year, once we cycle through this, we'll paint them over white. They'll be out there the whole year, and then we'll get 80 more people opportunity to paint over there. So if y'all get a chance, swing by the nature park and check out everybody's art. They got 2 weeks to complete their little canvas, their masterpiece on the parking spot. So pretty cool. That was a good idea that she had. But like I said, there was a lot of people there this weekend. So other than that, just revving up for the summer, getting ready. I don't know if y'all have any questions for us, for me. I know you guys have the scholarship stuff, but
you have an event coming up.
Is that Back to the Future? That's
Ours and Chambers.
Yeah, Chamber does market. They do these market days every other week downtown. Abel tries to get in there as well, and we'll do movies at the park, at the amphitheater there. and stuff. So we get a good turnout there on the weekends. And then now that the summer's coming up, every 2 weeks we'll be rotating parks where we'll be showing the movies at the park. We don't have the lineup yet. You know, we don't have the movies selected. We got to get licenses. But we'll put all that stuff out once we get the brochure released, the digital brochure.
I was going to ask Sergio, on some of these activities that we have, there is fees for some of these activities, right? Like for...
the programs, yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, your stuff at the parks and stuff, movies at the park, that's free.
Yeah.
We do free popcorn and stuff like that. But yeah, whatever it is, your programs and your camps, registration through Active, there's minimal fees for that.
Just to make sure that people know that there is a fee.
Yeah, we do have small fees. It's just to help offset the cost with some of the t-shirts and stuff like that we get for the kids at the end of the year. We're getting ready for the tap swimming, golf, tennis, track. We're getting ready for all that. And then we got games at Texas here in Brownsville for the next 2 years. So it's really close. So hopefully we can qualify a bunch of athletes and send them over there. Wow. Nice. But that's in July. So we got some time.
Hot July.
Yeah. But it's like staff said, we're just kind of, I don't know if Adam threw it out there, but we're always hiring lifeguards. Always.
Yes.
So anybody who's out there listening, you want to apply to be a lifeguard, your kids, your nephews, whoever, we will certify them. Adam does all the classes, certification, CPR, and we need instructors for Gus and Goldie swimming. So that's now. We're hiring now, getting ready for summer. We're opening June 3rd, I believe. That's what it was. It was Saturday, June 3rd, if June turns to Saturday. So that's one of the positions that we struggle a little bit more filling is the lifeguard ones. There's so many cities, water attractions, facilities and stuff. So it's, you know, you divide all that. But we do have to hire close to 100 lifeguards, and it's challenging. So if you guys know of anybody, spread the word for us, please. And we'll take care of the rest. But yeah, your Gus and Goldie swimming and all that stuff. We'll have another meeting, right? But all that'll start. Everything cranks up first week of June for us. But I don't know if y'all have any questions or all that stuff. So.
The registration for like Gus and Goldie and for the swimming and all that, is that currently open?
We haven't opened it yet, no. Okay. No. That one, once we put the brochure out, that'll have all the information.
Okay.
Depending on how many guards we're able to get for summertime for the seasonal, because right now we have X amount of guards, right? We have the natatorium, we have the water park open, we have some splash pads that we got to maintain. So if we were, hey, you got to do swimming lessons right now, we can't. We don't have enough, we don't have the staff. So depending on where we get that number to, and we like to be close to about 80 or 90 total, we'll be able to do swim lessons morning and afternoon like we always have. But if that number doesn't reach that number, you know, the hiring doesn't reach in the 80s, we may have to trim back a couple of classes. So we don't want to set those hours yet until we know how many kids we're going to be able to hire. So yeah, we're going to give it a little bit more time before we lock that in. So it'll be probably by next meeting, the brochure, everything will be finalized. We'll have a better idea. But yeah, and everything's online. You can register for any of the programs online on Active. Most of our parents and stuff are really good about it. They already have accounts. So it's just logging into their accounts and choosing the activity program that they want to do. But that's all I got for the most part. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Okay, the next item, letter C, discussion and action on awarding youth activity fund a scholarship recipient.
Good evening, Elva Guajardo, Administrative Assistant for the Parks and Recreation Department. As submitted to you all, there was a total of 6 applicants for the scholarship. 3 girls and 3 boys from PSJ Southwest, PSJ North, and PSJA. So at this time, I leave it open for discussion to see your nominations and the awarded amount that you will be providing these applicants.
Do we have a motion on who, well, obviously we all got these and we went over them and, you know, read them on our time. And I'll open it up for a motion for any, if any recipients are gonna be awarded, or how many, how much, and, you know, let's just open it up for a discussion. Or a motion, actually.
Well, I'll make a motion. The two people that stood out in my book were Paris Ramirez and Sofia Rodriguez. So my motion is for Paris Ramirez and Sofia Rodriguez to be the recipients of our scholarship.
I know that I personally felt the same way about the two or all of these applicants, but I also chose Paris Ramirez and Sofia Rodriguez. I don't know if anybody else had any input before we get a second. Do we get a second as far as nominating both or one or? I know that the motion on the floor is nominating both two females, Paris Ramirez and Sofia Rodriguez. Do we have a second?
A second.
And the amount would be $1,000 for each.
$1,000 each. We got a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Congratulations to those students.
As soon as I get the information from the counselors, some have already, I already have, but so I can invite you all to their awards ceremony. Some of them are starting late April and going into May. So if one of you wants to participate and distribute the award, you may do so. Thank you.
Thank you. Item D, discussion and action, if any, on a second potential fundraiser. I know we had to discuss that we had have the first one.
Again, as previously discussed in the last meeting, you all wanted to have an additional fundraiser for your account that you have. So at this time, I leave it open once again to see. I know there were some ideas brought up for a soccer tournament, golf tournament. But the plate sale, we do, we're getting the tickets ready. So it's going to be for July 29th. So I should be distributing tickets no later than Friday to all of you. So again, I leave it up for discussion and action, if any, for a second potential fundraiser.
Yes, so I previous meeting I had proposed a second fundraiser, perhaps since we're Parks and Rec, we could do it at the soccer facility, Plaza Sports. Every 10 to 12 weeks we have one weekend where it's either very slow or we close because that's the end of our season. So we can have that weekend for a fundraiser for us. I just think that it would be beneficial to switch it up. I think the plates are great, but it would be fun to see if we can get like teams to register. We can discuss it being all around youth. We can discuss it being a two-day tournament, which is what I would suggest. We do a Saturday and a Sunday, three guaranteed games, and then finals. 8 to 10 teams per division.
Get the mic.
Oh, yes, sir. Sorry. And then we decide how much we would want to charge for a registration fee, which would be the main income. And then we can charge an entry fee. We can sell concessions. I think it would be a good amount. So I leave it up for discussion. I think we would have time if we plan for the fall, because this plate sale is July. maybe even August. I just don't know how teams would feel in the summer. So maybe it could be a September, October, November, even. Thanksgiving, I already know that's a great weekend. We will be closed, so there are some holidays where we're closed, and there's potential for tournaments. I know that Roel would be, and I mentioned it at a previous meeting, would be a huge help. He knows a lot of teams. We do too, but maybe we've always wanted to have a Thanksgiving tournament. We just have never done it, but there is interest, so that could be one as well. It really would be up to us to determine this is what we want. We just want it this size. We want it to be bigger. We want to invite teams from all over the valley.
So potentially in the fall, there might be a day or two that might be available.
Yes. Yeah. We can, if there's interest, can start looking at the calendar, and then we can just, if you all like Thanksgiving, we can... fine, we can do that. Or if there, or if we prefer another one, we can just book it, and then we work our league around that date. Mm-hmm. We make flyers, we start spreading the word, we invite teams. We would pay for very good. I mean the board. The Parks and Rec. We would have to buy very good awards so that there's interest in participating. And that would pretty much be all our expenses, and then additionally maybe just for sure staff to help. But the soccer facility would be free.
What about the officiating, whoever's in charge, is that staff that takes care of that, or you would have to pay for the officiating? That's something we can work on once we establish a date and, you know.
I got volunteers. I have a lot of teachers that are volunteers that are TASL certified. More than sure they'll be willing to give up their time to go out there with the kids, especially
great.
For the cost.
Okay.
That was going to be my question. What grade level or are we talking?
We can get together and say, you know what, we want it to be just competitive, or we want it to be, I suggest recreational too, very, very popular. But then, I mean, we start as young as four. We can do four. And then the older teenagers are not that interested anymore, I would say, till like 13.
Okay.
So that's a very good.
Those divisions.
We can do girls too. There are some divisions where there are enough teams in the valley that are just girls. We could just do an all girls division. We can do 2 years, you know, like we do 2007 and 2008 play one division, stuff like that.
No, I think it's a great idea.
I mean, in a 1 weekend, we can fit perhaps 80. 100 teams.
Wow.
I mean, we could, yeah. And if we charge 100 to, I don't know, what do you think would be for like a local term? I mean, from 100 to 200, maximum 250 per team.
Entry fee?
No, for the registration fee per team.
Oh, yeah.
And then entry fee, you just charge maybe something low, $5 for both days, bracelet and for the
okay.
families. Entry fees are good revenue, and then concessions too. We would not open our restaurants. We would have concessions from, or we could have the restaurant open. But I mean, there we sell like food, tacos, burgers. That would be good to have for people. And then we could do so many other things like T-shirts. We can be, you know, Parks and Rec can buy T-shirts and sell them for the parents that are. We can get sponsors. I forgot sponsors. Sponsors are big.
Mm-hmm.
That's cash and carry. On the T-shirts and the trophies.
And the trophies and the medals. And the concessions.
So It's definitely a more complex fundraiser, but we have plenty of time. I just think if we're Parks and Rec, we can do it. And then so my question would be, whatever money we fundraise, would this be for scholarships as well?
You can use it however you want. This is your board money.
So I would suggest then, if we're gonna do that work and create a new fundraiser, and it's gonna take work from all of us, I suggest upping the requirements for the scholarships. If we're gonna go ahead and say, okay, we're gonna use all this money for scholarships, we might wanna see a few more things. We might wanna have more criteria. Yes, for awarding scholarships. And we might be able to do higher amounts. Those are my two cents.
Pizza party.
I think it's a good idea also.
We
just
can get like
set up
lunch
a date
for the board members here, dinner, right?
Right. Any other discussions on fundraisers or that particular idea?
I think that's a great idea.
Start having more funds, perhaps we could even create divisions. Say we want to award someone based on athletic performance,
right.
And we feel
categories
strongly about this athlete from Pharr, and we want to, yeah, we could have
mm-hmm.
different
like
sections, right? I mean, one for who's applying
school
for something in medicine, or we have so many that apply for that. We can just make it a little more challenging.
Very good ideas.
Okay.
We have the tickets. We'll send pictures of it to y'all so y'all can see it before we print it already.
Okay. So.
What proceeds?
Yeah, so, I mean, obviously the barbecue set. Now, on this other fundraiser idea, I think it's a great idea. Like I said, he echoed. And I think we need a date on it if we're going to go for it, unless we table it and decide on a date for next meeting, because it's still a ways off.
Would you all agree or like for me to perhaps propose 2 to 3 dates and maybe discuss with Sergio and
yeah.
see if they
you
work.
All a text
yeah,
or
I think
an
that's
email.
A great idea.
And
yeah.
then we bring them back next meeting. We
date.
Vote on
we'll
a date.
Do that.
And
yeah.
then
but definitely a soccer tournament.
Yes.
Okay.
That's a good idea.
Okay, we'll do that.
So your motion is for a soccer tournament.
Yeah, that would be the second.
That's a second.
Second.
All those
the second
in favor for a second fundraiser being a soccer tournament.
Aye.
Motion carries, and we'll get the ball rolling on that.
Most definitely.
Okay. Last item, board members, any more comments or anything that we need to discuss?
Well, other than, I mean, the department is doing a great job. I mean, in all aspects, from painting to the different activities that are coming up. And I mean, it's gonna be the busy season. Just keep doing what you're doing. You're doing a great job. And I mean, what else can you ask from you all and your staff? I mean, they're doing awesome.
The organizing is what takes a lot of work, and they're doing a great job. So
yeah.
Kudos to you guys.
I don't know when the next meeting is, our next board meeting, but just in case we don't make it, HubFest is May 20th, so everybody's obviously
right.
invited. If you guys do show up, let us know, but it'll be May 20th outside downtown. I don't think we've locked in the lineup yet for the entertainment, the talent, but they
the
do 17th. Well, they have locked it in. I don't know the exact order and stuff, so yeah, but they're posting everything already, so it'll be May 20th is Hub Fest.
May 20th or May 17th?
20th.
17th is our meeting.
Oh.
Oh, okay, so yeah, I could have told you all the 17th, but yeah, May 20th is Hub Fest.
Okay. Any other comments? Anything? Item number 3, adjournment. We have a motion.
I make a motion.
We have a first.
Second.
We have a second. All those in favor for adjournment?
Aye.
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 Motion carries. Meeting's adjourned.